Hey everyone. Okay, so I have a little trick for solving fourths and fifths, and they're basically the same rule with one like tiny little tweak in there. And it comes from looking at all the fourths and fifths. So, looking at all the fourths, for starters, this is every possible fourth without any sharps and flats. So we have a fourth that starts on C and goes up to F. D, E, F, G, A, B, a fourth on every one of these notes in bass clef and treble clef. So basically, this is C and F, and above it is C and F, bass clef, D and G, treble clef, D and G, all the way up. Do you notice that there's only one that is not perfect? It's B and F. As a fourth, when F is on the bottom and B is on top, they make kind of a darker sound than all the others. The others sound very smooth together. But if you get to that fourth with F and B, it sounds different than the others too. I kind of think of them as being in their natural state, no sharps, no flats, or maybe you think just white keys on the piano or just C major if you're thinking scales. So this is every possible fourth, and every one of them, except for F and B, is perfect. So, there's a great way to solve these for quality because of this consistent pattern. And we're going to look and see that fifths, it's the same idea. They're all perfect when they don't have any sharps or flats, except for when it's B and F. And since B, C, D, E, F, B to F makes a fifth instead of a fourth if B's the note on the bottom. And in this case, they're going to sound strange again. But diminished instead of augmented. So, here's how this works for solving things. Well, since we can see fifths, let's do a fifth first. So, this is a fifth. Now, I know that with no sharps or flats, they're perfect automatically because they're part of one of the ones that are perfect. The only one that's not going to be perfect in this way is B and F. But the cool thing about this is, what happens if I do have accidentals on these? What if I have C sharp and G sharp? Well, they've both moved up exactly one half step each. So the distance between the two of them has not changed. They both just went up one rung on the ladder together. But the distance between the two notes has not changed at all. So it turns out C sharp and G sharp, basically the notes having the same accidental, the notes matching accidentals, I always say the notes match, means that they're still perfect. So, perfect, also perfect. What happens if they both go down one? Well, has the distance between the notes changed at all? No, it has not. They both just gone down a half step together. So that's still perfect. So as long as one of these normal fifths, the ones that are not B or F, which we have to watch out for, as long as it's one of the normal ones, if the notes have the same accidental, they're perfect. Now, the cool thing about this also is that if they're not, let's say that we have C sharp and G natural. So normal G and C sharp. Now we know when they match, if we ignore the accidentals completely, they're perfect. So now we just have to question, well, then what happened? What does that sharp do to the distance between these? We know that if we make the distance between these two notes smaller, it becomes diminished. If we make the distance between the notes larger, it becomes augmented. So what do we have? C sharp went up a half step towards the G. Well, that means this guy just became diminished. What if we have, just for another example, let's say we had a normal C and G sharp. Now what happened? C to G without any accidentals is perfect. So that means if they spread out by one, because G got farther away from C, the distance between them has gotten larger, then we also have an interval that's not perfect anymore. It's a half step larger. Well, one half step larger than perfect is augmented. Let's do a couple more examples. What if we have C flat and G natural? When they match, they're perfect. What happened to them by C going downwards a little bit, a half step specifically, C goes down a half step. That spreads the distance out again between these guys by one half step. So this is also augmented. Okay, here is C to G flat. So with none, they're perfect. G has gone downwards a little bit. Well, that means the distance between them, they're closer together now because G has gone downwards towards the C. And therefore, we have a diminished fifth. This method works really fast. Just look to see if they match as long as they're the normal ones. If it's B and F, just watch out and use one of your other methods like counting whole steps and half steps, or use your major scale method. But for any of these, it's going to be really, really easy because we just look and see if they match. If they have the same accidental, then they're perfect. If they don't, well, then we just have to decide, did it get a little bit bigger by a half step or a little bit smaller by a half step? So let's do a few. I'm going to switch to bass clef, and let's just do a couple of fifths. D and A sharp. Now let's go peek up here at our fifths. D and A are one of our normal pairs, so when they match, when they both have the same accidental, they should be perfect. These do not have the same accidental. So the question is, did it get bigger from them being matching, or did it get smaller? Well, if we ignore the sharp, it would be perfect, right? Because they would match, they would have nothing on them. And that sharp raises the A by a little bit. So by raising this note, they get farther apart. Therefore, this fifth is augmented. It just got bigger by a half step. Let's try another one. Okay, these two notes are F on the bottom, C on top. So let's make this bottom note sharp. So if they had no accidentals on them, they'd be perfect. So did the distance between the two get smaller or larger? Well, F went upwards towards the C. So that means the distance between these guys just shrank a little bit. This guy went up a rung on the ladder while the guy up top waited. So that makes this fifth smaller by a half step, making it a diminished fifth. Let's see how this works with fourths now. So with fourths, it's the same thing. Just watch out for B and F. Use a different method for B and F. Use your major scale method or count your whole steps and half steps recipe. But for fourths, we're going to do the same thing. As long as it's not F and B together, we're in great shape. It's really fast to solve fifths and fourths. So let's do a couple of fourths. Okay, E and A, that's a normal fourth, and they match, right? So if they didn't have these flats, they would be perfect. They both went down the exact same amount, so they're still the same distance apart from each other. They match, they're still perfect. So this is a perfect fourth, E flat to A flat. Let's do a hard one. Let's do some double sharps. Double sharp. Okay. If they had nothing on them, they'd be perfect. The G went up one, the C went up two. So the C went up just a half step farther with the double sharp than the G did. The other thing we can do is if they both have been sharped at least once, so this is a sharp and a double sharp, we can take the bottom sharp and the top sharp, and basically in our minds we can ignore one of those sharps. They've both been raised once. So I could, if I wanted to, cancel out one of the sharps here and take one of the sharps off the double sharp as well. So I could take the sharp off the G if I really wanted to kind of cancel out, do it in a mathematical way, and cancel one of the sharps off that guy, and that would end up like that. That's easier to deal with, because now I see, oh, the top note was just raised, that must be augmented. But let's do it back with our double sharp and our sharp, and just think, well, if they didn't have any, they'd be perfect. This one went up, but then the top one went up again. That made the distance between the two a little farther, and therefore it got bigger. Well, that means I have an augmented fourth. Let's try one more. Okay. They both have at least one flat, so they both moved down at least once together, and then the bottom note has moved an extra flat. So that means that these two notes without anything are perfect, because it's A and D, it's one of our normal sets of fourths. And then they both moved down once together, and then the bottom note moved extra far down. So that fourth, the distance between those two notes has grown by a half step because this guy went down an extra rung on the ladder downwards. So that makes this fourth also augmented. So that's my kind of quick and easy method for solving fourths and fifths. If they match accidental-wise, they're perfect, unless it's F and B together. That pair of notes don't like each other so much. So you got to watch out for F and B, but if you see any other pair of notes as fourth or fifth, then you should be in really good shape. If they match, they're perfect. And if they're not matching, then did the distance between the two spread out or did it get smaller? And then you're set. So quality for fourths and fifths should be a piece of cake. Okay, good luck. I hope that helps.